Welcome to all. In this video we will discuss module 3 integral calculus, and the topic is beta and gamma function. So first we can understand what is beta and gamma function. After that we'll solve some results based on the beta and gamma function. So introduction of beta and gamma function. In this topic we define two special functions, that namely is beta function and another one is gamma function, by means of integral and study the associate properties. Okay, so why we used beta and gamma function? This is also by using beta and gamma function easily we can evaluate some integral calculus. By using beta and gamma function, some critical integration easily we evaluated by using these two functions. So first we can discuss a relationship between the beta and gamma function. Yes, so this helps us to evaluate a certain definite integral which are either difficult or impossible to evaluate by various known method of integration. So some type of difficult or impossible integration, it is not possible to solve the ordinary method, that ordinary way or any other way. If it is not possible or if it is difficult, means that type of integration easily we solve by using gamma and beta function. This is one of the best application and best use for the to evaluate the integration. So first we can define what is beta function, and next we can define what is the gamma function. So definition of beta function. So the symbol is denoted by beta. Okay, so beta of m comma n equal integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 1 minus x power n minus 1 into dx. So this formula and this integration is called beta function when if m and n greater than 0 is called beta function. So this is the formula, you should memory this formula. Okay, and this function is beta function. Next we can define gamma function. So this symbol is denoted by gamma. Okay, so like this. Okay, is denoted by gamma. So gamma of n equal to 0 to infinity e power minus x power n minus 1 into dx n greater than 0. So this formula is called gamma function, or this function is called gamma function. You should memory this formula. So this two formula and this two functions are very very important. One is called beta function, another one is called gamma function. Okay, this is the gamma function. So next we can discuss what is relation between beta function and gamma function. So this is the important questions. So see, this many times they asked in the university paper. Okay, so relation between beta and gamma function. Prove that beta of m n equal to gamma of m into gamma of n divided by gamma of m plus n. So first we have to identify what is beta of m comma n by definition, what is gamma of n by definition, what is gamma of n by definition, what is gamma of m plus n by the definition. So first we can define every form in the definition. So what is beta of m comma n? So 2 into integral 0 theta equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2 m minus 1 into theta cos power 2 n minus 1 into theta into d theta. This is the another formula of beta and gamma function. And next, this is beta of m comma n. Next, gamma of n, that is equal 2 into integral 0 to infinity e power minus x square x power 2 n minus 1 into dx. So take this for equation 2. Next we can define gamma of m. So gamma of m equal 2 into 0 to infinity e power minus y square y power 2 m minus 1 into dx. See, if it is n, means n function, here I am using x variable. So here m function, this is n, and here also n. Clear? So this is m, here also m. One first I am used x variable, next I am used y variable. Clear? This is gamma of n, this is gamma of m, next gamma of m plus n. So if gamma of m plus n means here I used gamma of m plus n, and first I used x variable, next I used y variable, here I will use r variable. So this is equation 4. Now gamma of m into gamma of n equals, so 2 into 2 4 double integral 0 to infinity e power minus x square plus y square x power 2n minus 1 into y power 2m minus 1 into dx dy. So next we have to solve this equation by using polar form. Okay, so this is the Cartesian form, we convert to polar form. How to convert to polar form? Cartesian form convert to polar form, dx dy equal to r into dr d theta, and also x equal to r cos theta and y equal to r sin theta. So every term it is a Cartesian form, so each and every term we can convert to polar form. So gamma of m into gamma of n, this is x square plus y square, so r square cos theta, r square sin square theta plus r square cos square theta, and this is x equal to r cos theta and x equal to r sin theta, r into dr d theta. So each and every term we can convert to polar form. So this term I will write in the two term, one is r term, this is r term, and another one is I will write theta term. Okay, one is r term, another one is theta term. So 2 4 is a common, so 1 is 2, I'm taking 2. So this is clearly, this is r interval and this is theta interval. Clear? So first I will collect r interval 0 to infinity, this is r term, so e power minus r square, this is r power 2n minus 1, r power 2n minus 1 plus 2m minus 1 plus 1, this one r power. Okay, so minus 1 plus 1 cancel, we'll get r power 2m plus 2n minus 1 into dr. This is r term, and 2 into 0 to pi by 2, this is theta term, sine 2m minus 1 theta cos 2n minus 1 theta into d theta. So by the definition, see, this is equation 4, see e power minus, this is equation 4 and this one is equation 1. So this is equation 4, this is equation 4 and this is equation 1. So gamma of m n equal, this is beta of m n, sorry, this is beta of m n and this is gamma of m plus n. By equation 1 and 4 we can replace this term to gamma of m plus n and this term to beta of m n. So what we will find, what we have to find, that is beta of m comma n only. See, so beta of m comma n equal to gamma of n into gamma of m plus n. So this is the relation. So this is the important question. So most of times in university exam they ask in this question only. So next we'll discuss based on the problem. Okay, I hope you all understand this one. So this is nothing, first you have to identify what is beta of m comma n, that is equation 1. Next you can define what is gamma of n, that is equation 2. And next you can define gamma of n, that is equation 3. And next you can define gamma of m plus n, that is equation 4. And next one, equation 5 is nothing, gamma of m into gamma of n, gamma of m into gamma of n. So this equation you have to solve by the polar form. Okay, polar form. After that, finally, you can use equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, equation 4, will get the solution. Okay, so that's all. I hope you are all understand what is the application of beta and gamma function, where we used, and what is the relation between beta and gamma function. Okay, so once again, I will explain where we used some type of difficult integration or tough integration. It is either will not get the solution by ordinary method, means that type of integration easily we solved beta and gamma function. So next video I will explain the problem, the integration how to solve the integration by using beta function and gamma function. Okay, so next video we'll discuss.